Hey, I'm Manuela with Plytix. As you hopefully already know by now, in Plytix you can manage all of your product information efficiently by creating as many custom attributes as you need in order to store all of your product data. But it's also important to know that every single Plytix account comes with a set of system attributes. In this video, you'll get an overview of what these system attributes are and how you can use them. If you don't know what an attribute is, you can learn all about them in the video that I'm linking up here. And I'll also link supporting documents and videos that explain the concepts that I'm going to be talking about a bit more in depth. Every Plytix account, whether you request an empty account or one with sample data, will come with system attributes. These are there to help you get your product set up and to help you manage them effectively. System attributes are easy to spot because they have the SYS prefix, while custom attributes have the ATT prefix. It's important to know that unlike custom attributes, system attributes can't be deleted or renamed, and while some of them require value, others are optional, and some have values that are automatically created by the system, but are view only. If this seems a little bit confusing, don't worry because I'm gonna break them all down for you. First up, and most importantly, we have the attribute SKU. SKU, which is short for stock keeping unit, is an alphanumeric value that's unique to each product. In Plytix, it's your product's unique identifier, so naturally, the SKU attribute is required for every product that you have in Plytix. In fact, it's the only required attribute anytime that you import data into the system so that we can ensure that the information is linked to the right product. Keep in mind that the SKU attribute is case sensitive. A product with the SKU AB123 in all caps is different to the product AB123 in lowercase. So be very careful when creating products, as well as when editing them, to make sure that it's the correct product. Next up, we have product ID. Product ID is also an alphanumeric value and also a unique identifier in Plytix. The difference between SKU and product ID is that the SKU is a unique identifier in your account, while the product ID is a unique value that's automatically assigned in the background to every product that's created in Plytix, not just in your account. And unlike SKU, you can't change this value, it's view only. So let's say you import a product with the SKU AB123. On creation, the system will automatically assign a product ID. If you change the SKU of the product to, say, AB456, the product ID will still stay the same. Now, this is because the product ID is used as part of the URL for the product page, like you can see here, and it's also what's used when making API calls. Now, you won't see this attribute available in most parts of your Plytix account, like the product overview table or the product details page, but you can, however, export it from the product overview or from a channel if you need to. Next, we have the GTIN attribute. GTIN stands for Global Trade Item Number, and this can be an EAN number, a UPC, or a JAN. This is an optional attribute, meaning that you don't need to input a value for it, but if you're using a GTIN number, we do recommend putting it in the system attribute rather than making a custom attribute for it, because the GTIN system attribute offers a level of data validation. It only allows valid GTIN formats, and you'll see an error if that GTIN number is already being used on another one of your products. Next, the thumbnail attribute. The thumbnail attribute is the visual identifier of your product around the Plytix platform. In order for the image to render properly, it should have a JPG or a PNG extension. You can add the thumbnail attribute to your product overview table in order to get a visual representation of your product, and you'll also see it on the left-hand side of the product details page. There is also the label attribute. This is a short text attribute that's shown on the product's detail page underneath the product thumbnail. The label gives you a way to easily identify the product because, let's be honest, the SKU isn't always self-explanatory. We recommend including keywords that will help you find the product faster. For example, here I've labeled this product the Dear XL Sweatshirt 2XL. This way I can quickly search for any of these words and this product will come up. The next system attribute we'll talk about is the status attribute. This is a dropdown with three possible values: draft, complete, and archived. This attribute helps you get an overview of the lifecycle stage of the products in your account. But if you sell on more than one channel and a product is available on one channel but not on another, then you can always create a custom dropdown for each channel. Now let's talk about the variations and variation of system attributes. These are two attributes that work together. This attribute helps our system understand which products should be connected and how. And it also helps organize products in Plytix. So if you look at a product's detail page, you can quickly see if the product has variations or if it is a variation of another product. The system attribute variations is defined on a parent level. So if you have a main product that has variants, the variations attribute will include the SKUs of these variants. The system attribute variation of is defined on a child or variant level. If the product in question is a child variant of a parent product, then the variation of attribute will include the SKU of that parent product. I know this can get a little confusing, so if you want to learn more about variations, how to set them up and view them and how to work with them in Plytix, then you can check out the link that I'm leaving in the description of this video. And we're also coming out with a video that goes in depth into all things variations. So make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell so you can be notified when that video is up. Next is the system attribute categories. This is a really special attribute because it's a multi-select attribute with a twist. It allows for hierarchical selection and it's the only attribute of its kind in Plytix. This attribute creates category trees, so you can assign products to multiple categories that can be up to 6 levels deep. For example, the sweatshirt is in 2 different category trees, which makes it easier for users to search for it. Next, let's talk about the assets attribute. This is a unique attribute because it lists all of the files or the digital assets that you have linked to a particular product. Meaning, when you assign an asset to a media attribute, this asset will also show up under the system attribute assets. And if you unlink it from the product entirely, it'll also be removed from the system attribute assets. You can see the system attribute assets by adding it to your product overview like this, or by clicking on a product and heading to the assets tab. Mind you, this assets tab shows only the assets that are assigned to this product. If you unlink an asset from here, it won't show up here because it's not linked to your product anymore, but it'll still be available in your account and you can see it by heading to the All Assets page in the overhead menu here. Next, we have the created date and last modification date, which are 2 view-only system attributes. The created date shows you the day and time a product was created in Plytix, whether it was manually, by import, or through our API. This is automatically added by the system and it can't be changed or deleted. The last modification date is also added by the system, but it's updated automatically anytime a product is edited. There's also the system attribute family. This is also a view-only attribute, and it's automatically updated whenever you add or remove a product from a product family. You can learn all about how product families make it easier to manage your products in Plytix in the video that I'm linking here. And since we're talking about families, pretty soon we'll have a new system attribute called family models. So stay tuned for that. In the meantime, if you have any questions at all, feel free to reach out to your customer success manager or talk with a member of the Plytix team by using the chat on our website. And of course, if this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more product information, tips, and tricks.